Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now I'm gonna give you the latest update on what is going on with Invest. Already at 47 miles per hour wind, so it's already strengthening up, and it will go straight to a tropical storm in the next day or two. I'm showing literally in the next 24 hours, and showing it is going to strengthen. It has a good chance to become a hurricane. We already knew this, but it has a chance to become back and forth. It can be a strong hurricane and start weakening back down from this dry air and the shear. Shrinking back up again to another chance for a hurricane, then weaken back down again. It's going to be a roller coaster with this storm. The good news, the only good news I can see out of this is GFS, Euro, and the Euro artificial intelligence is seeing the same place almost the same time. Wednesday evening, 7 to 10 p.m. for landfall on Louisiana. I'm gonna show you the latest information and potential impacts. That way you know exactly what's happening in your area. Remember, I do have links down below so you can zoom in and see what your potential wind gusts and your rainfall amount is as this potentially comes on landfall. Also, it will update as the new runs come out and you'll have updated information. You can zoom right into your backyard so you know exactly if you're in the impacts or not. All I ask is if you know someone in these impacts, please share this information on other platforms or just hitting that like button down below. That does so much for new people to see. Thank you so much for your time. The best thing we can do is practice safety and help each other get through this. I appreciate every single one of you. And you do see it is at 90% in the next 48 hours, 90% in the next 7 days. Showing it does not have a well-defined center yet, but it is producing winds 40 to 45 miles per hour on the western side. Tropical storm is also expected to form during the next day or so. Then it's going to move northwestward and then northward. And strengthening is possible by the middle of this week. And showing it will go up and down still. I'll show you the latest information. Still, the main threat is showing it will be along the Gulf Coast of Mexico, Upper Texas, and Louisiana. Plus, tropical storm watches could be required for portions of the coast of northeastern Mexico and southern Texas later this afternoon or tonight. Now, the hurricane hunters are en route and dealing with this system now to see if it's stronger than we actually see in the model data right now. Latest intensity guidance has gone up, shows chances to go right towards that hurricane, even some is bringing it to a low-grade cat. Two now, and we all know how the Gulf of Mexico is, but still seeing some shear, still seeing some dry air in there. What I'm showing is it's going to do a little roller coaster effect. But you see, after you go, as soon as you go 24 hours away, it could be as early as 24 hours, or more than likely could start reaching a peak as it goes towards 72 hours. But even then, remain a tropical storm for additional 24 hours while it's on land, and a tropical depression after that. Now, this is just the update so you can get a nice, quick, up-to-the-point update. You can see right here with your Euro chance for your cyclone tracks. After it starts strengthening, it will curve, getting pulled by the upper level low, and go right towards Louisiana. You can see the same thing on GFS, showing the same information. You can even see this on the Canadian. It is all trending more than likely where this storm system is going. Strength of the system, you can see with the GFS showing it more likely will be a strong tropical storm on the edge of becoming a hurricane. Even some take it to where it could just get a little crazy for a moment, but that's not the average. And when you look with the Euro, you can see almost the same thing, but the Euro is showing a little bit weaker at times, but it has picked up the pace. Chances to become a strong tropical storm to a hurricane, also agreeing by the Euro. And when you go by the Canadian, try and find the trend, you can see it does meet towards that peak as you go in towards Wednesday. It starts strengthening up towards a strong tropical storm towards that hurricane. The only thing that is in agreement right now is a 977 hurricane by 10 p.m. on Wednesday. This is by the GFS. You can see this also by the Euro, 979. And as well as the artificial intelligence of the Euro, the one that saw all this first, showing it could be a little bit sooner. It could travel faster and be early afternoon, like 1 p.m. rather than 9 or 10 p.m. So keep that in mind, it could be earlier. But you can also see as it goes towards landfall, it brings a big wind field with it of very powerful winds. Now, usually where this is, where you have 60 miles per hour winds or more, you are looking at power outages and all of that white all the way up in towards Mississippi as well. Just be aware this is strengthening, staying somewhat a tropical storm, and then it's going to go down towards a tropical depression. But you can see how far northern it keeps those strong winds. Artificial intelligence of the Ural, that as that tries to strengthen up, you can see it still gets that cheer in there, that dry air on the western side, pushes all the moisture off of the center. So it does try to strengthen, even gets a good chance to go back and forth to a low-grade hurricane. I think that shear and that dry air getting in there, if that still remains to show true, is going to be our saving grace from this doing any kind of intensification. Plus, I believe it's going to go quickly, and it's going to start running out of time. Just trying to go by what kind of winds you could be looking at. If you look down here, you'll see chances for 60 miles per hour sustained winds as it grows through the evening. But as you go in for later on, look how it grows towards a chance for a hurricane for tomorrow. Gets all the way down towards 84 miles per hour sustained winds around 1 p.m. for tomorrow. But then look how it loses itself all over again. Probably going to go up and down. Then it tries to go right back towards a hurricane again. Then it loses itself. Then it tries again to become at least a Cat 1 hurricane. You can see that it just tries multiple times to strengthen up to at least a stronger Cat 1 hurricane. You can see this with Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B. Gives it a stronger chance to where as you go through the evening, then once you get into tomorrow, then it starts raising up. And instead of 80s, it shows chance for 92 miles per hour sustained winds. That would be a strong Cat 1 hurricane. Now, there's a bunch of comments of people wondering about their hometown. What's the wind? What's the possible rainfall? What's the updates you can do best for my backyard? And I totally understand that. These links are in the description below. This is for your rainfall amount. You can go by the Ural or GFS, and you can zoom all the way into your backyard and see what your potential rainfall amount is. You can see it starts adding up. Once you go from Wednesday through that Thursday, then it starts coming on shore, bringing the storms and the heavy rainfall. You can also see this with GFS. It's not just Ural. And you can also see with the Icon, which is only a five-day model. Icon takes it where it goes way up on land, gives it a good hit of heavy rainfall coming with this, a lot of flooding. Also, I have this for winds. It's for wind gusts. You can see this with the Ural. It has strengthened up, bringing chances all across Louisiana, moving more over Mississippi into Tennessee with the high 50 and 60 miles per hour wind gusts. Now picking up chances for those high 70 miles per hour wind gusts to come with this. According to the Ural, we look for GFS. It's a little more consolidated to the high 70s, almost the 80s, but it's the same region. See this? Look, GFS, Ural. Look at that. Almost exactly the same. Now, we still got to pay attention to this weather pattern after it comes on shore and does all the things that it's going to do to everyone. You can see with GFS in the next 4 days, the amount of rainfall that's going to come out of that. You can also see with the Ural, they're almost exactly the same. Now, this blocking pattern potential, look at this. As it comes on shore, it could sit there and just spin and bring more rainfall almost up to the next 8 to 10 days, potentially. You can see this with the Ural as well. After it comes on shore, you get that blocking pattern, and it starts adding up to that heavy rainfall. Hopefully this update has helped you relieve some tension of what is going on with this system, and maybe newer information lets you know maybe what you might need to prepare for as far as some sandbags for the flooding that's coming, or maybe board up some windows if this wind keeps picking up even more. I will keep you updated first thing in the morning. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. And hope you have a very great night tonight. Now, a quick message from our Father, 1 Timothy 6:17 through 19. Charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy. That they do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to distribute, willing to communicate, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. I will keep you updated first thing in the morning. Remember to check on your neighbors and your neighbors' pets. Let them know what is coming around the corner. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, all glory does go to God. Our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And everyone that is around you. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. I'll see you in the morning.